just got a baby inside.
And now you can
hey guys, welcome back to our channel. So today we are on our way. We are headed to our first fertility doctor's appointment. We have decided to start up our TTC journey again, and we are actually going to do reciprocal IVF this time. So that's what we have today. Once we get to the appointment, we will come back and let you guys know how the appointment went. Do you have anything to say? You're nervous, excited? Excited but nervous, and I don't know why I'm nervous, but that is how I'm feeling. Once we get there and get out, we'll explain everything then. See ya. Look at the camera. So tell them about the appointment. I don't got nothing to say right now. Cause somebody don't know when the hell to hush. Just stop talking. This is not funny.
Okay, will we get ourselves together? When we get ourselves together, we'll come back and give you guys an update on how this appointment went.
I'm not that personal with y'all yet, so I'm not telling you what's going on right now. Just know that she would not stop talking. She don't listen to nothing. She just kept going, like the Energizer Bunny just kept talking and talking.
Why the gas station right there?
And talking. I'm sitting there like, hey, please come. Oh my gosh.
Yeah, I know.
And what she
means.
Did, she kept talking. She asked for another motherfucker to come in the room. I'm sorry. I ain't supposed to be cussing at y'all, but I need y'all to understand how serious this is. This is terrible.
Alright, guys.
Overall, it was a great meeting, but that's all I can say for right now, because I gotta focus on other things.
Like a laser. Like a laser. See ya! We back to finish this portion of the vlog to give you guys an update on what happened at the appointment and how we are feeling about everything and all the information that was given to us. So, we went in. And we talked to the doctor. First we went in, we filled out new patient paperwork for me. After that, we went to the bag. They did my blood pressure and got my weight and last day of menstrual cycle, all of that information. Then we waited and we talked to the doctor. We like this fertility clinic than the last one. We told you guys that we were going to. The energy was different. The people were friendlier. They seemed more into making sure we knew everything that was everything that went into the process of different ways of getting pregnant. And one of the routes we're thinking about going is reciprocal IVF, which, if you don't know, it would be me carrying my wife's eggs. So we went in, and I just want to say sorry for my tone. My head is killing me, but I just wanted to get this finished because I want to start completing the stuff, the tasks that I say I'm going to complete. But anyways, so we met with the doctor. She came in very friendly, seemed to know a lot about the LGBT community, which was great. You know, she gave us stories about past patients that she had. She was concerned about, you know, us being married and things like that. Just making sure that we are, so that the baby is covered by both parents and not just one, if anything should happen to either of us. Or, you know, we decided we wanted to go our separate ways. She wanted the babies to still be, the child of children to still be covered by both parents, able to see both parents. No one has more rights than the other, basically. So I thought that was great because comparing it to the last fertility clinic that we went to, they didn't talk anything about anything as far as rights for the second parent or anything like that. Granted, at that time we weren't married, but still, she could have said something, because at that time same-sex marriage was legal. So she told us everything about reciprocal IVF, all of the shots and medication Jazz will have to take. And let me get her in the shot. She's cooking, so this is why she looks so focused. But she told us all the shots that Jazz will have to take. She also told us she told us a lot. And even though I had been doing a lot of research, and I've informed Jazz on the research that I've found, and, you know, talking to different people, I think it put it in perspective for her. So you want to tell them how you feel about this process?
Sure. How y'all doing? Don't give me too much pressure about not looking in this camera, because I'm trying to feed us. But anywho, got dog. So this place that we went to today was, in my opinion, 10 times better than the first place we went to. The first place we went to, I told her that we were never going back, because I didn't like certain things that they did. And then after having certain things like, I'm a very people person. They weren't very friendly. They were just more so, okay, like, let's hurry up and do this so you can get the hell up out of here. Y'all are lesbians. This shouldn't be going this way. And quite frankly, I don't give a good goddamn about your personal opinion about what I do with my life. I ain't affecting your life in any type of way, so leave me the hell alone. And that's really the way I feel about it. I ain't saying you and your heterosexual people.
You, ma'am, you getting off topic.
I'm serious. But this is the way they made me feel. You can't ask me how I felt and then tell me you getting off topic. That's not fair. So.
Okay, speak your truth.
She just, that entire place just didn't give me good vibes at all. It didn't make me feel it wasn't a very comfortable feeling. And the whole time I'm there, I want to say something, and she's like, oh no, be nice, play nice, you don't know these people, give them a chance. And I told her while we were there that I don't care for this place. I don't ever want to come back. And I say that, I really do mean it. I'm very serious about that. But this place today, The doctor was very informative. She gave us a lot of different options that we would have. Gave us a lot of good information that she think we needed to know. And different things like having a lawyer involved, just to have that that extra security for the other parent, is by far one of the best things I think I've ever heard. If somebody really cares about your process, then they should be doing things like that.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what they did. She was very knowledgeable about the things that she was talking about. I was just very impressed with the fact that they talked about having a lawyer involved. I thought that was very interesting. You could tell this place is really about business and they're about helping people, not necessarily looking down on whatever they think is wrong. Because it's not, once again, it's not really about them. If you have a business and you tell me you cater to every type of individual, when these type of individuals walk into your business, you don't show your ass. You just try to get the job done.
How do you feel? What's your feelings on the whole process of reciprocal IVF?
Make you pause for a second, because you be sitting there like, what the hell did that lady just say? She just said 15 million shots. She probably didn't say 15 million, but I'm sure that's what I heard. I was sitting right there. She was like, oh yeah, it's just gonna be a lot of shots here and a lot of shots there and some drawing up some blood. I don't do needles. That's one thing I don't do. I don't do needles. I have a whole meltdown trying to go and give blood to anybody, because I don't like needles. So, it don't seem like once we do this, I ain't gonna have no damn choice but to get on board with some needles, even though I don't want to.
So, her liking the clinic is a plus for us, because at least now we know where we'll be doing. We'll know who we will be talking to in helping us create our family. Give me 1 second, guys. We'll be right back. Anyways, so we're back. Little commercial break. But so, yeah, her liking the clinic is great, because now we know who we are going to go with to start our family. The doctor is amazing, so we don't have to worry about them not feeling like they won't have the best interest for us. Dr. E is thebomb.com. She is awesome. So now we are just trying to figure out if we're going to do the reciprocal IVF, which, let me explain, you guys. The only reason I'm really pushing the reciprocal IVF is because, one, I know she doesn't really want to carry, because of the way pregnancies have gone in her family. So I understand that, I get that. And two, I want her to be a part of this process as much as she physically, mentally, financially, emotionally, as much as she can. So I felt like the reciprocal IVF gave us all of that, you know. Besides, I think my wife is very, very beautiful, and I would love to have a little or a few little people.
This is where I draw the line. Don't start back up.
A little person or two running around that looks like her. That would just be so awesome.
The world is not prepared for that.
But that's why I want for us to go the reciprocal IVF route, you know, because of that. But if she decides that the shots are just too much, then then we will go the IUI route and see how that works for us. So the next step for me, well, us, but me in this us, will be testing. So I'm just waiting for my cycle to start, and then I'll call them on day one of cycle, I mean on my next cycle, day one. And we'll take it from there. So yeah, I just wanted to come give you guys a little update. Did you have anything else that you wanted to share so far in this journey with them, feelings, thoughts, anything?
Anybody that has done the reciprocal IVF and that was not carrying, I would love to hear from y'all, get y'all perspective on things about how this process was for you all. Was it something that you would do again? Whether it was positive or negative situation, I would like to hear the thought processes on it and what your experience was, just to compare to the experience that I possibly will be going through soon and very soon. So y'all let me know. I think this will be an interesting little journey. I try to keep y'all updated as much as possible. I probably won't. I don't pick this camera up too often.
We're working on it.
Well, when she talks, I'll try to get on here and talk to you, even if I don't feel like talking. And we shall go from there.
With that being said, guys, we're going to do our best to document as much as we can throughout this journey. Not only for you guys to help someone else out, but just so we can have it to look back on once we are successful, once we confirm pregnancy, once baby is born, or babies.
Why she always gotta bring up stuff like that?
I'm so sick, y'all. But anyways, I need to get over this cold. But yeah, so like, comment, subscribe to our channel if you are new.
Call at me. I just want to know what y'all going through. And if you ain't going through it yet, what are some of the concerns that you may have going into a process like this?
Yeah, because it's a lot.
Whether you're married or not. Because yeah, that part really doesn't, that don't really matter. Just make sure you have somebody who has your best interests at heart when you're going to do these processes. Because just because it say that they are LGBT friendly doesn't make it so.
Yeah.
Y'all be careful of the people that y'all allow to have your information, whether they are professionals or not. You can have a building and have a doctor and that doctor not be professional. We've all watched Married to Medicine, so we all know that.
Anyways, but on that note, we're going to say goodnight. Thanks for watching and stay tuned, because this is going to be a crazy ride, because we are committed to this journey this time. We feel more prepared, we feel more stable all around, emotionally, financially, mentally, you know, all of those things. We just feel more ready this time. So wish us luck, wish us love, wish us baby dust, and we'll see you guys on the next Baby Willis update. Oh my gosh, how exciting. I just got excited thinking about the chance of Baby Willis. Good night, guys.